Hello and welcome back to Factorio. I'm Avon. Now, in the last episode, we set up a train station down here. This is going to be for science. I have changed my plans completely now and decided that we're going to do some restructuring of the episodes, because if we go directly for science, it's going to be a struggle to have enough parts to make the arrays. And after making the arrays, we need to supply them. So I'm going to do some mod making and some bot making. But first, let's continue the trip up here, because we definitely need to get this pipe going. And there is a small issue up at the making of the nuclear fuel. So let's move over there. And while that's happening, I'm going to change some stuff up at the red chips. I'm going to redo the stations. Let's not get overrun by a train while moving here. Good. So this station is horrible. And that's going to be changed right now, because we don't have any incoming copper, which is nice. So I'm going to change it into a four wagon setup. Now, Spidertron is going to remove this chest, because this chest will actually make a clog at some point, I believe. Because this one might fill up with the dark stuff. So we remove that. And we remove these two, because we did the recycling and we don't want these two to fill the belt, because we want priority. Now, what I also should do is probably tear down all of these. So while Spidertron is up there, let's do... Actually, we can do the inner ones. Let's see. So let's remove these. And leave four of them up, I think, like so. And Spidertron is going to have a whole lot of nuclear stuff, so we need to fix that at some point. But for now, inventory is doing fine. That's good. We're also going to remove this belt as it runs out, but not yet. So let's send you home now. Let's go down here and let's finish this one up. So do we have one that turns right somewhere? If we do, then we can copy that. Looks like this one does. That's a bit quicker than turning it ourselves. Yeah, that's good. Oh, but can we fit a balancer? Let's see. So if we remove all of this, let's look at a balancer. I think we have, oh, there's one. We can if we remove a belt. No, hold on. If we, how about we make it that way? This is, completely balanced because we don't actually need the last ones. The last ones has to do with something I don't remember now, but it's not needed in many cases. And I think, and well, let's say I hope this is a good case for that, because let's see, this belt gets split into these two and the outer ones. Yeah, so it's definitely split into all of them. So it has to do with like weird throughput and stuff. So let's find this train. You can go manual. You don't go to the copper pickup anymore. Actually, we send you to red chips and wait for empty and full, so it never moves. That's nice. And then we move this so the train arrives. Good. We also need, what do we need? Inserters. A bunch of inserters, actually. Okay. And chests. This isn't made right. No. Good. And we place you like so. And instead of copper pickup, you go to copper smelt east for full cargo. We move you up there. And remove this and send. I think that's fine. Should be. So that puts less of a strain on this station, which is good because this can't supply much at all. This is going to be removed at some point, I believe. And we just need the inserters now. I also don't want to cross all of the train tracks because we do have, we do have assistance on that. Where's our train track crossing assistance bot? Oh, about that, about our Spidertron. Our Spidertron has been named. So let's do that officially. Spidertron, your name is Aurora now. That's good. Thank you for that. And it's kind of fitting, Aurora, I believe. I believe it might be a reference to the ship, the large crashed ship in Subnautica. And I like that. So, Aurora, welcome to the team. Okay, so now we can cross train tracks. And we need inserters. I'm going to put a bunch of inserters in the Spidertron, I believe, in Aurora. That's it. Here we go. And how are we doing on the inserter making? We're doing terribly. Because each inserter needs so many things. So let's help it out a bit. That should double it up. Yeah. If we can, we move this. Nah, it's okay like this. This probably isn't though. Now, what I was thinking is I'm going to make a station that makes bots and modules. And that is going to help us out a lot because I might make some bot-based stuff. So let's send you back to the depot. Let's loot all the productivity modules. We probably get more from the train as well when it arrives. I also want these. Yeah, that's good. So if Spidertron gets those, or I can borrow them, but I'm going to, let's see, apply them here. Oh, we also need the chests. And logistics. I'm not sure if we're actually making the steel chests. I seem to remember we had this issue before. So where's our chest making business? This is going to be hard to find actually. I have no idea. There. Oh, all the colors. Good. There we go. Three of them, sure. I'm going to put a logi request because we use a lot of them. Like so. I wish Aurora could request stuff as well. But I guess if we're going to have a personal ride and a building ride, we should have more than one Spidertron, but that's an issue for later. There we go. Okay, so now this is going to fill up and this is probably going to drain because our plastic is abysmal. Before we do that, I have a list and the next part on the list is, that's it, modules. Is science. Now, the science, oh, this is terrible. We don't have many at all. Oh, they are producing at least. And that's why I need a module making base. So we're going to do more science. And that's going to happen as we get modules for it. I'm going to have to stay until these are plopped down because I have the modules for construction here. There we go. That should double up our speed. And let's do... Oh, let's not start the science just yet. Let's place some modules. Now, we start, always start, with the most expensive one. And that would be probably blue, because I believe we have modules on the yellow. Yes. We don't have modules. Well, we don't have fully moduled the purple. Are we going to use the purple science? What do we need anyway? Probably this or this. Probably this, because that's cheap. So, not doing military just yet, so I'm going to place the modules here. And let's see, maybe here, can we? No. Rails? Oh, we can't anyway. So we can't use modules on the between products here at all. Oh, here we can. So I'm actually going to upgrade the assemblers here. Assemblers. There we go. I'm going to make this like so. All of the assemblers. Plop, 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 plop. And then I'm going to place it like so. Now, this is going to slow down the production a lot. So let's get some modules. Or beacons. Moduled beacons. I don't know. Here. And here. Sure. We don't need that much. It's just to keep up some of the speed. Because these are quite slow anyway. Yeah. So, that was the purple. Now we need the blue. And, oh, this is going to cost quite an amount of modules. Quite an amount. So let's start on the edge, because those are the ones that produce first. Ah, that's funny. We placed before they upgraded. That's fine, actually. So, what we're going to do here is we're going to use modules in base, so we can have science fully moduled and actually do science. So let's start here now. And I know it slows it down by a lot, but I'd rather have slow speeds than more consumption, because we don't have much material. And then we're going to do a small change down at the mining. This is turning into one of those maintenance episodes, but I like that. I like running around the factory improving stuff. So here we're going to make spaghetti, because we haven't made spaghetti in a long, long time. And that's this thing. Some people have mentioned it, that it's not the best solution because we don't drain the base, and I agree. So I'm going to take that advice, and I'm going to use that advice to make spaghetti. And up here, let's do one. Oh, that's good. And then we go here, and input priority to the right. So we use this first. That's the point here, and that's going to drain some of the iron, and then we're going to do the same with this, because I believe these are full. Not really. That's good though. Oh well, I'm going to prioritize it anyway. Input priority left. Good. The copper is almost out, it looks like. Yes, I think, let's see, red, I'm looking for the green lights, but I don't see any copper moving. I think it's only this one. 200 more. Okay. So let's remove this. I'm probably going to mess up the power now. Let's see. Oh, a glyph. Okay. Blowing up the base. Sure. And there we go. There we go. There we go. I'm going to remove the rest when this one is empty. There we go. We probably have some copper ore now. Yes. And there we go. Almost put it in the wrong one there. That would have made stuff difficult. Okay, so our copper patch just got tiny, which is nice. Might even tear down the power plant down here after, but this one. But we'll see. We'll see. And then we're going to do a small change to plastic. Let's see. Do we have a request for modules? Why aren't we requesting modules? I want them to prioritize me instead of building train. There we go. So let's place these while we're at it, because we are actually using science now. There we go. Oh, that's nice. Wait, this is wrong. These get product first, so let's halt these for a bit. And when we have more modules, we're going to start them up again. And again, it doesn't matter if the science is slow, I just want it moving slightly. So, plastic. Our biggest limitation in the factory right now are red chips, I believe. They empty out really fast, and we don't have enough input for them, so I increased the copper. Let's now look at the plastic. Plastic is running out quite quickly. Well, only one chest at least, which tells us that we don't have enough. We wanted to buffer up. So I haven't done any numbers here, so this is going to be one of those wonky things, but let's look at it. So these are placing on the belt. This one is as well. This one isn't. So if we move, let's say here, and then we shift the belt down here like so, that's nice. Yeah, that is nice. Okay, just that one is temporary as always. Let's do some counting now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So they need 5, this is 6, that's fine. I'm not going to change it, but I am going to do output priority to the right on this one, so the excess goes to the other station. It is a bit hard building from the Spidertron. It moves not because it has like momentum, it moves less accurately than I do. And I don't move that accurate, so that's it. Like so. And how do we want to move this? I guess we just shift it down here. That's fine. And then so, I think. Yeah, let's skip this squiggle while we're at it. So we do. Oh, the trees. No. There we go. And here we go. All the trees, please. And we ran out of belt. Okay, let's place this though, so we can just come back and finish it later. Do we have a belt on Aurora? No, not many. A few. We can place these. And we can tear down a couple of more trees here so we can actually see what's going on. So this one, let's see, this one is going up. And this one is going up. That's good. This is nice. You go here. What's going on here? Okay, yeah, we're going to bring you up here. And then this one. This balancer is needed. This one is. No. What's the plan here? Doesn't matter as long as they're connected, actually. So let's send a building train up. Let's see. Here. Go. Good. This is going to increase our plastic by so very much. So let's enter Spidertron so we can move across the train tracks and get some belts and some undergroundies. And then we place some of them in the machine. And good. Okay, that should help a lot. Now we can actually finish this. Let's see. So you go here, you go here, and you go here. And then everything is set. Now, this is not balanced at all, which is completely fine, because we only have three belts going into eight. I kind of wanted it to be balanced. Let's see. Let's split this. This is one of those wonky things that won't make any difference, but it will look better. Now we have 1.5 belts going to each side. So we just tripled our plastic, actually. That's nice. That's really nice. So, where are we going to build our modules and bots? I was thinking down here, since we had a station, but I kind of want to save that for the science. So not building here. I'm going to stay away from this part of the tracks. That's the wrong side of the tracks. So module. It would be nice up here because we could belt stuff, but I'm okay using the trains. So let's do here. Yeah, I think here in the corner. Sure. And I forgot where we're going. In the corner. There's coal here. We might need that at some point. No, we're going to expand. We're going to go down here. So let's get some shooty stuff for Aurora so we can remove the evil biters down there. That would be, let's see. Military science, military stuff is here. Ah, let's cross. Yeah, this is going to be fun. I know Aurora doesn't like this part, but I do, so we're going to get used to it. Oh, yes. Go, 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 go. Yay. Okay, that was fun. That's fun every time, actually. So, the joys. Let's get some modules while we're at it. we go. And let's place the modules while we're at it. What just happened there? Did I place them in the spider one? Yeah. Okay. And then we have 1, 2, 3. Oh, now we have death. No, that's fine. So let's get some rockets. 700, that's nice. Let's bring these as well. They went into my inventory, but the others were loaded into Spidertron. Maybe we can do some mixed shooting. I don't know. I don't really know how. Crap. No. There. This is going to mess with inventory space for a long time. I don't have a clue what I took now. It's fine. Let's get rid of this. Oh, radars here. Repair packs as well here. And not substations, but power poles and turrets. We need turrets in here. Turrets, good. And I forgot what I was doing. Oh yes, we loaded rockets into Spidertron. So let's get rid of these. Yeah, that's a good. Oh, hello. Okay, oh, here we have an issue. Let's sort that issue first. So one of these, this has been long coming. I took the bots, didn't I? Yeah, so let's go bots. This thing need bots as well. So let's find them. Construction bots. How many? 10? 25. That's fine. And we need big electric poles. We need turrets, I guess. We need more turrets on us now. And repair packs. So are we requesting turrets even? Yes. And why do we not have more? 48, that's such a weird number. Let's go with 50. And let's get them. We're going to need the turrets now. We make them at the batteries, probably. Here we go. Yeah. Let's get all of them. And then give a stack to Aurora. Okay. Ah, oh, this is nice. Now it's draining and is copper drained? Yes. So that's nice. Now we have room for more, I bet, spaghetti down here. I don't know what we can build actually. So we're done here. Let's look down here. And while we are moving, let's bring power with us. Hopefully biters won't eat any of these. But I think if we remove the bases down here, we're going to have a lot less attacks going that way anyway. So let's... Ah, this is sneaky. Ah, there's a cliff as well. I turned on. It's possible to turn on the auto-targeting so Aurora can go wild. I'm actually taking... Am I taking damage? Not really. The shield is taking damage. Yeah, this is... Annihilation. Good. Aurora is doing great versus spiders, and with the building, and with everything. I feel safe inside as well. Even if the shield is taking damage, There is still like a huge age people. And the age people gets repaired. So we're quite safe. Let's get the power down here so we can place radars. And also, if we have enough turrets, which I think we do, let's block this area off now. Let's do our this thing here. That would be here. Let's do one more. Let's see. Oh, we need to make sure they don't go through here as well. Well, it doesn't matter if we make too many. So let's make too many. And then we just remove it while when we expand more. So here and here. Now we don't have any repairs for this. And I'm not going to build repairs for this. This is going to be one of those places where if it gets destroyed, it gets destroyed. And or possibly we'll send Spidertron down. Oh, yeah. We're going to clear out that one as well. Oh, we have one more science. We have worker robot speed. That's nice. One more tech. Oh, this is so convenient. Oh, there's a big base down here as well. Let's see. Let's look at the pollution. It's actually not reaching. So that's nice. We're not going to clear that one. If we start going off on a killing spree, we're going to meet more and more and more bases. And that's going to take a full episode. We might do an episode of killing. It would be fun to see how Aurora deals with being equipped with a whole bunch of lasers and just murdering stuff. But for now, this is about the... What is it about? I forgot. Oh, it's about our new station. This is nice. This is really nice. I guess the pollution will go a bit further now because the spider nests won't absorb the pollution. But I'm okay with that. Because worst case, another base absorbs the pollution and it's the same result. But many trees down here that can absorb some pollution as well. Let's get this camp and then we're set to build. So what I am going to build is I'm going to make a bot base that makes bots, and because it makes bots, it's going to be self-replicating, self-growing. I'm going to start with a tiny amount of bots in there and then I'm just going to let it run, and it's going to make bots and use the bots to make more bots, because that concept entertains me a little bit. So where do we want this? We want it on this side. And this is also going to be a copy paste because we're only going to use one train per station. Actually, I don't know if that's true. So I'm going to get the parking spot as well. So let's use this to split it off. Let's see. I think we could go like this, but I kind of want it close up here because then we can place the parking here and then go down. I'm going to try this right now. I'm looking at the time and we have spent a bit of time on the maintenance, but that was needed. We basically tripled our plastic. I'm still so joyous of that. And my droid just went away because we don't have enough coal. We don't have enough petroleum. Ah, this is nice though. We hit another bottleneck. So I guess we... Yeah, we hit another bottleneck. Okay, well, that's always fun. Because it shifts the issues. So if we... I want to make the crossing last, actually. So if we go here, that's going to be here, right? Yes. And then we get our parking here. Missing the in light. Need to remember that. And we need to turn it. Yeah, this is nice. This is nice. So here, I guess. This way we can add many, many more if we want to. And we add this. And we add a chain signal. Why do we have a chain signal there? Because if this one, all of these are red, this one is red. So why do we not have a chain signal there as well? That's not a chain signal. There, good. It's not good, it's not working. Because why? If this one is red, this is red. That's good. Maybe because of this. Maybe it's just overkill. No. It really doesn't matter. We're not going to fill it up anyway. Rail signal. But it's more that I don't get how that functions. Maybe it has to do with coming in. No, it's still not working. Yeah, that's confusing. It's not breaking the color, actually. Maybe that's the issue. Let's get one and try further down. Yeah, it's not breaking it into a new section. Maybe I am turning it the wrong way. I didn't know you could turn these. I thought it automatically did so. Doesn't look like it matters though. So if a train... Oh, it might have to do with... No, this place does have light, yeah. I don't know. Let's look into that later. It's fine. And confusing, but fine. So now we can get the split off. If we can get through all of this, yes. Good, right side, looks like the light is fine, looks like this is fine. Is that how chain signals work? They have a visual? Looks like it, okay. Good, so we're probably going to need the building train for this, but this is the parking for our automatic mod and bot making bot based base, and that's going to be so much fun. So let's see if we can place these so we avoid the blinkies. It's nice to keep the alerts for Alerts. Oh, and here we have an actual alert. An important one. Nah, just... They killed a bot, though. Oh, that's why we need a bot making base. That's bot-based. Because we need to resupply dead bots. Good. No more blinkies, except an important one. So, maybe, maybe this place should get a visit from Aurora at some point, or maybe the murder train. So if we look at these now, if we do, let's see, I'm just going to see how it works. It works quite well, actually. But maybe we go like this. No, we're going to make, that's for the next episode. That's for the next episode. We're going to make a bot-based train station, because that's how I roll. No, it's going to be great, I think. The only thing we're missing, I believe, what do we need? We need red chips and green chips, and we need iron, probably copper at some point as well. Maybe not, but we need green chips, steel, yes. So no copper, but green chips, and we also need red chips for these. So, yeah, and we need batteries. That's the thing. We need batteries. So the batteries we might make locally, or I don't remember all the things we need batteries for. So maybe we should make a huge battery making place, or we can combine. That's fine as well to combine. Anyway, that's a problem for another day. So, Aurora and me, thanks you all for watching, and we hope you enjoyed the spaghetti. Bye-bye.